Should you upgrade if you already own a Mini 2? I'll give you 5 reasons to consider. That's of course also relevant to first-time buyers too. Camera upgrade. A bigger sensor is always better, and at the same 12 megapixels as the Mini 2, the Mini 3 provides even larger pixels. In combination with one-stop wider aperture, letting the double amount of light into the sensor will enable better performance during night shooting. Mini 3 shoots 4K HDR with dual ISO on chip level. This is supposed to reveal more details in the highlight and shadows even during harsh daylight. This will help you unlock the dynamic range directly out of the camera. 4K HDR video is enabled per default and is supported by 24, 25 and a maximum resolution of 30 frames per second. Extreme low angle shots are now possible with a large tilt angle because of the revised gimbal design of the Mini 3 series. With single mode, it outputs a 12 megapixel HDR JPEG photo for increased dynamic range. And of course, if you want to take care of the editing business by yourself, a RAW option is also available. True vertical video. Whether you like it or not, vertical video is here to stay. With the Mini 3 series, it's possible to flip the camera physically just by the tap of a button. This is something that we haven't seen since the original Mavic Pro. I guess that one was a bit ahead of time. And what's super cool about this is true 4K, where you get 100% benefit from the larger sensor. There's no cropping of the image, which you had to do in the past, leading to lower resolution. It works for quick shot as well, and this will allow you to capture better vertical scenes like skyscrapers, waterfalls, and in this case a water tower, allowing you for more creative angles. If you're doing YouTube Shorts, Instagram Reels, or TikTok, this will not only increase your production quality, but it will also ease your workflow. The noise level. I was actually pretty surprised by the difference firing up my Mini 2 after not flying it for a while. You really forget how quiet the Mini 3 series actually is. It's only when you're putting them head to head, you really notice the difference. And I can say without any doubt that the noise level of the Mini 3 is superior compared to the Mini 2. It's like a flying ninja and not a Karen magnet, as we have seen a fair share of here on the channel. A dedicated smart controller is convenient because I promise you, once you have tried this, you will never go back. From the time where you arrive on location until you are airborne is remarkably shorter without having to mess around with wires and cell phones and all sorts of stuff. Some of you might say, this is nothing, I can easily handle this. But having this dedicated controller that's only meant for doing one thing and to fly the drone alone is so convenient. And this is definitely, if you can afford it, a luxury that you should give yourself. I find myself flying more frequently because of this. It flies buttery smooth with the smart controller, with a solid connection within the distances that I normally fly. And I can finally get rid of the previous generation of smart controller that, despite many efforts from DJI, never worked out really well for me. With the DJI RC, you can pop in an SD card and record your flight through the DJI Fly app in case you want to do that. This is something that's very useful to me as a content creator. I wish DJI would bump the resolution to 1080p on the screen recording, as right now it's a bit to the low side. Longer flight time. You get 38 minutes on paper. This is 3 minutes longer than the Pro version, and it is 7 minutes more than the Mini 2. But these numbers for all 3 drones are, as expected, nowhere near real life results. I'm getting anywhere from 20 to 28 minutes of flight time depending on usage with the Mini 3. One flight was under heavy wind, low temperature, and in sport mode with wind warnings all over the screen, really pushing the drone to the max. I was exceeding the level 5 wind capabilities and the flight time was cut down to around 18 minutes. But the drone still handled pretty well as long as you're not making stupid decisions flying with the wind away from the shore, as the drone in some cases will not have enough power to make it back. There's also a plus battery option that will extend the flight time to 51 minutes. This will of course increase your flight time, but this option is not available for EU drone pilots. The comments below. This is what it looks like if you compare all 3 models in a table. You will be able to buy the Mini 3 in these configurations. As with the Pro model, there's no charger included. Yes, there are things you will not be able to do compared to the Pro version. If you desperately need those features, you have to hone out those extra dollars and get the Pro. I think this is a really good candidate for first-time drone buyers. I also think this is a really great update from the Mini 2. If you have decided to pick one up, there is, as always, purchase links in the description below. I do want to say neither of the Mini 3 drones supports third-party apps. If you depend on those, you might want to hold on to your Mini 2 for a little bit longer, until DJI decides to release a SDK for Mini 3. I hope you liked this video. If you did, then feel free to give a like. If you didn't like it, feel free to press the dislike button twice. Thank you for watching, and I'll be seeing you around.